Hey there, friends on YouTube. My name is Roger with Electronics and Gadgets. If this is your first time here, thanks for stopping by. Hit the like and subscribe, please. If you've been here before, thank you. For my next video, I'd like to do one for the Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra and an app in the Samsung store called Galaxy Enhance X. So let's go ahead and just go to the store first, and I'll show you where to pick this up. So you go to search. I'm in the Galaxy store. We want to go to Galaxy X, and there it is, Galaxy Enhance X, actually. So I already have it downloaded. The main reason why I'm doing the video for this is it's just been updated. And it's got some really cool features that I wanted to go over with everyone. So that's number one. The reason why I'm doing the video is it's updated. And number two, some of the features have been added and really made pretty neat. So anyway, let's go ahead and open this up. First thing you want to do is you want to select your picture or your video. So we're going to select a picture all the way to the bottom here. And I picked this picture, say that 10 times, of a night moon, a moon scene in the night with some trees. Okay, so there's multiple things we can do here. Some of them are self-explanatory, some of them I'm gonna go over. So magic is one of them that just enhances it. So we're gonna hit magic, it's gonna do its thing. And now you can see a before and after. You can just see it made the image much better, much brighter, brought out more details, etc. So that's one of them. Colorize, we know what colorize is. It'll colorize the picture. Remove reflection. This is the one I want to do, 24-hour time lapse. I don't know how they, obviously this is AI, and I don't know 100% how AI works, but this is amazing. So let's go ahead, it's going to touch up details. So now it made a short video that goes from bright to dark, back to bright again, just out of that picture. I mean, that to me is so cool that they're able to. It's a 12-second video, but what they did there was pretty darn amazing just based off of that picture. So it'd be neat to know what other things can happen with other pictures that aren't necessarily, you know, something with the moon or the sun, or I guess this could be a sunrise setting too. I never thought of that. That's why they did that. So it's not necessarily the moon. I said the moon in the beginning. It could have been a sunrise set. So we're going to cancel this and continue on with the different things. So that's the first side. That's the suggestions. The next one is color bright, make it an HDR picture, which is usually pretty neat. Very high qualities, so you can see the differences again. And then you can tune them in to make them even more pronounced. So now you have a regular, the first picture, and then the differences. And if you notice, even right here in this area, there's something there. It looks like a city of some sort. And here, you can't even see it. So it really enhances the picture. So we'll cancel that. There's another colorize. There's a bandage, remove reflections, fix blur, denoise, sharpen. A lot of things that are some basic things of graphic programs, but they're all built into this one program, so you really don't need another one. Face, if there was a face there, you could rearrange people's faces. You could make it into a portrait. You can fix lens distortion. Creative, there's another, that's the same one, 24-hour time lapse. Sky guide, I'd like to actually do a review of that someday. You click on this, though, it says picture needs more stars to show sky guide. So it's doing something. If you get a picture of a sky, you click on that and you're going to get some some probably constellations and stuff inside of it. Very neat stuff. And then we have, of course, your crop, your basic crop, increase resolution. Right now, the picture's all the way cranked up at 4 megapixels, so it can't go higher than that. Transform, that's what I just went over that. So that's basically it. That's all the different things you can do in this. And like I said, it did a lot of new updates into this. It didn't have all this before this update, and it's really evolved into a pretty powerful AI app for the Samsung. So I hope you found my video to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please click like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below. Click the new thank you button if you're really pleased with my videos. And until next time, I'm out.